Very excited today. My son just had a baby this morning. I'm thankful for that because my son, him and his girlfriend have been together for 12 years. And she's white and he's black and my grandson's blonde hair with blue eyes. And the one that was born today has dark hair and dark eyes. And I'm already realizing that there's going to be some things that they have to deal with in this world in regards to protecting one another, standing up for one another. And it's so unfortunate because our children shouldn't have to, we as parents shouldn't have to look forward to our children having to stand up for each other. It should be all right for them to be kids. It should be all right for them to be people in this world. It should be all right for them to go to work and live in communities where they want to live, go to schools where they want to go, work where they want to go work, even go to the parks that they want to play in. It should be okay. But we're not in that world, right? And so I've been protesting because I want the world to be better. I was hoping that I could get the world better with all the people that were uprising around the world because we had so many civil rights and so many human rights movements. And I knew that with our generation that we understood our history and that we could unite together to finally do something, right? We haven't got there. This movie, Who Streets, the thing that I was thankful about, that was shown in it. I hear a lot of times people are saying, I used to be out there in the streets with you. We used to show up, we used to come out. And that's cool to show up at a protest, but the reality of everything that we're dealing with is that if we're not looking to change policy, if we're not looking to change social circumstances, if we're not trying to change policy and legislation in our communities, if we're not trying to elect municipal leaders, that can not struggle with the courage and the integrity that it takes in order to make change, but have that definite, serious, if they're not running to change the world, then I don't think they need to run at all, right? I don't think that we need complacency. I don't think that we need acquiescence. I don't think that we need a generation that's gonna wait for someone to tell them what to do. I think that we all know what's possible. We all know it's honorable. We all have these children that are looking forward to our, you gotta excuse me. I'm so emotional. I'm speaking for my great-grandchildren. I'm not speaking for my grandsons. I know what they're gonna have to deal with in this world. I know that when they go to school that there are gonna be kids that come to their classrooms that are being told not to play with them. I know when they go to the parks that they're going to pick up somebody else's toy and that person's parents are going to say, get away from that kid. I know when they go to high school, they're going to fall in love with somebody that don't nobody want them to be with. I know and I hope that it doesn't happen, but I bet you before they're teenagers, the police or somebody's going to call them a nigga or going to stop them from doing anything, from breathing, from walking, from talking too loud. Somebody's going to tell them they're a problem just because of this. I know that's going to happen. I'm 47 years old. I've watched it happen in generations of children. I know that it happened because my grandma was from Louisiana and she told me about when it happened back in the 20s, 40s, 60s. We're in 2017. We're having the same conversation. We're human. We're having the same conversation about race, and we're human. Decent human beings, like real people that actually bleed and live and have families, moms, dads, grandmas. We're still talking about why we can't get along in the world. That's weird to me. It's not easy for me to talk about it because it's just really weird to me that somebody would look at somebody like me, a human, obviously with five fingers, two legs, two arms, a body, a head, a brain, ears, nose, all that, and could look at me and say something's wrong with me. Every last one of us looks different. So if something's wrong with me for looking the way that I look, then there's something wrong with all of us. And if there's something wrong with all of us, that's okay, so we ain't gotta change nothing. Right? We can be who we are, we're strong, we should be okay with that, right? But we're not there yet. So my challenge is that so that our children do not inherit what's happening right now, so that our grandchildren do not have to deal with the guilt of what's happening right now, so that our great-grandchildren do not have to fight and read books about what's happening right now. Like, let's make that shit stop. Let's stop. in there.